Today, I'll remind you the things that you will need. You're going to need your notebook, your pencil, your water, and your mat. Also, before we even get started with anything, if you have your hair out, put it up. If you have like a necklace on that'll like hit you in the face, take it off. If you have rings on, I have all these rings, I'm going to take my rings off. Just so that we make sure that we're being super safe while we're moving. Okay? Now, we're going to dive right into it. Welcome to Sessions. This is class one, the four laws of movement. So, we got a lot of words up here. We're going to go through all of them, okay? So, what are those somatic sessions, right? Somatic sessions investigate movement principles, theories, and methods. Stop me at any point if you need me to answer anything or slow down. So, open level workshops supply participants with the fundamentals of movement. We will explore space, time, weight, flow, improvisation, composition, variation, and choreography. Written reflections will accompany physical exercises to promote interdisciplinary self-examination. Is that not clear to anyone? If so, let me know. All right, continuing. Over four sessions, participants will partake in an experiential system called Laban Movement Analysis for the observation, identification, description, interpretation, application, and performance of movements and gestures. Today's class focuses on the four laws of movement, which are time, space, weight, and flow. Each workshop added check-in, discussion, warm-up, activity, choreography, cool-down, then writing. It'll be the same. Class two focuses on the eight basic actions or content. Class three covers the six basic motions or quality. And class four finalizes the equation with the eight basic elements or seasoning. Content plus quality plus seasoning equals flow. Activities, dance, tasks, and written prompts ensure each participant completes the four somatic sessions with a toolbox capable of choreography, enhancing one's mind-body connection, and improving the way in which the sacred body is sustained, honored, and loved. Any questions, responses? All right, we will continue. So what does somatic mean, right? Somatic is an adjective that means of, pertaining to, characteristic of, relating to, or affecting the body. So basically, like anything that has to do with the body can be considered somatic study, but we're talking about the corporeal body. So if you're talking about like energetics and the ways that those things flux, those are less somatic. Somatic is more the physical body. Soma, and I don't know what language means body. I also drew these two lines and I don't know how to get rid of them. So if anyone knows how to get rid of these lines I drew, let me know. Okay, so in terms of Laban movement analysis, it comes from the person named Laban, right? Rudolf von Laban, yes, he is a white. Unfortunately, a lot of the dope people who were able to create and revolutionize and get noticed in the turn of the, you know, 1800s to the 1900s were white people. That doesn't take away from the fact that those people did find revolutionary things. So born in 1878, he was an early 18th century dance artist and theorist. He had a background in mathematics and architecture. So he formulated varying models for movement education, encouraging people to revert from leisurely moving habits to bodies active on the daily. So what that means is he wanted people to shift from this like post-industrial revolution way of like sitting and walking and sleeping and typing and sitting and walking and sleeping and typing, or more like labor-based activities. And he wanted them to focus on what are the ways that your bodies can be more engaged in everything you do on a daily. So Laban movement analysis outlines the fundamental laws and elements of moving. His practice is not solely for dancers, it is for all levels of movers. Laban reminds us that we have practiced movement during our lifespan, right? We have practiced like the theory and the principles of movement since our birth. It's just a matter of identifying, observing, and giving definitions for things. So in so doing, we're fully capable of observing, composing, and manipulating movement for the sake of mind-body equilibrium. So the first thing we're going to do today, after that, any questions, any comments? All right. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start right with our warm-up. What that means is get your mat out, and I'm going to be super loud. And what we're going to do is we're going to do an 8-minute warm-up. I would do it with music on any other day, but to be honest, I'm not feeling the potential of y'all not able to hear me. So we're doing all this without music. So like, I don't know what you need to do, but stand up, get on your mat, and let's get things going. Okay. We all need to start together for this to work. So I'm gonna check through and see that everyone's standing. Wow, what? This is so different online, yo. It is so different. Okay, great. I see people standing. I see people prepared. I see people shaking. All righty then. So what we're gonna start with today, everyone, is we're gonna start off with 60 seconds of jumping jacks, okay? So the first thing I want you to do is clap your hands, slap your arms. Slap your arms, slap your tummy, slap your legs. Good, slap your booty. Back. We're gonna get ready in 4, 3, 2, 1. 60 seconds, go. Jumping jacks. Good. Keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. Imagine your favorite song playing. Very good. I'm gonna keep going to this for 60 seconds. I will let you know when we stop, all right? I wish I had a huge timer, but I have one right here. All right, y'all, we're almost halfway through. Let's keep going. It's how you show you you love you. Get into it and get it. Okay, we're good. Keep going for 20 more seconds. Very good. You keep moving for 15. Very nice. Yes, we got 10 more seconds. Keep going. Very good. Make sure to bend those knees and bring it to a stop. Now we're gonna do 15 second push-ups on your knees. Everyone down to your mat. Right here, lift your legs. Very good. You're gonna make sure your wrists are under your shoulders. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down and up, down. Thank you. Oh my. 15 seconds. Down and up, down and up. 3 more seconds, down and up. Very good. We're gonna move to the next activity. 15 seconds of plank. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna get up into a tall plank. You're gonna lower yourself down and we're gonna stay here for 15 seconds. Make sure to breathe. Go. Breathe in and out. In, out. Good. In, a couple more seconds, out, in, out, a couple seconds, and release. Very good job, everyone. The next thing we're doing is a 30-second downward dog. So you're gonna get into push-up, gonna push your booty to the sky, try to get your heart to touch the ground. Just gonna walk it out for 30 seconds. Very good. Walk it out, like so. Feel free to turn your head right and left. Very good. You've got 15 more seconds. Breathe in and out. In and out. Very good job, everyone. Very good job, everyone. Bring that to a pause. Now what we're gonna do is a 15-second root chakra sit. So what this means is I want you to get into a position like so, right? I'm gonna stand this up for a second, sorry. Every day will be a little easier because we'll figure this out. So you're standing like so, a simple second position. Your feet are not parallel, your feet are on an angle. What that means is touch your hip bones, touch them hip bones. Very good. What? Oh, shippity-doo-dah, can y'all see me? I think they can see me.
You're like in the smaller video right now.
My bad, y'all. One second.
But yes, we can see you, Anthony.
You can see me? Okay.
Yeah, tiny, but we see you.
I think it depends.
How about now?
If you're on gallery view versus the speaker view, you can like switch it. Oh.
Understood.
Never mind.
Okay.
Did it switch?
All right. Sorry, everyone.
You're now
learning as we go.
Anthony.
Huh?
You're like
I'm the big spotlight. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Okay, so our legs are not parallel like so. Our legs are out on an angle. And the way that you know that angle isn't too far out is if you take your hands here and you put them on your hip bones, there's a direction that they go in. And the direction is on an angle. Make sure your feet are not parallel. They're on the same hip bone angle. Now what we're gonna do is we're also gonna make sure that our ankles are not super far out and they're not super far in. They're like pretty underneath our shoulders. And we're gonna do a root chakra sit for 15 seconds. So what you do is you're just gonna push your booty out, chest forward, so that you can go down very slowly. And you're gonna sit with your chest forward. Your chest isn't down, your chest is up forward. And feel free if you need to use your elbows to push out, push your knees outward. So hand here, we're gonna breathe in and out. Now let's do 15 seconds. In, out, say hi to the kitties, in, and out. 5 more seconds, in and out, in and out. Very good, come back up slowly, very good. And then the final activity that we're gonna do are 60 second squat jumps. And then we're gonna do this whole thing over, right? And then tomorrow will be faster because we know how to handle these technical difficulties, okay? So I'm gonna show you a squat jump first, right? And then you're gonna do it. So what you do is you first bend down, same thing, booty out, chest forward, right? You're gonna push your arms forward. Oh my God, I hope I don't hurt myself. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna jump, and you're gonna jump with the direction of your chest and come back down. Is that clear? I'm gonna do it one more time. Jump and then down, okay? These are called squat jumps. We're gonna, for 60 seconds, take your time. 5, 4, down, 3, 2, 1, and breathe. Make sure to go in your own time. Very good. We're almost halfway. Take your time. We are halfway done. Very good. We got 20 seconds. Breathe. Run. Breathe. Five, three, and end it. Come up slowly, shake things out a little bit, grab some water. We're gonna take it from the top. Boom. We ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 60 second jumping jacks, go. Keep your energy up. We're gonna be moving for the next 40 minutes. This is the way you tell yourself that your body is alive. You're alive. You're here now. Doesn't matter what happened yesterday. Tomorrow doesn't even matter. Because the two do not exist. Only right now. We're almost halfway through. Keep it going. If you get tired, push, push. Longer than you think. And because you love your body, you will push and breathe. Breathe, I can't see the time. Breathe, breathe. Good, 10 seconds. Get ready for your push-ups. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come out of it slowly. Get on the knees. Like so. 15 seconds. Go. Breathe. Breathe.
Good 5 seconds. And chill out on that jazz. The next thing we have are 15 second planks. Get into a tall plank, get into a small one. 15 seconds, go. Be sure to breathe, be sure to breathe. And stop. Very good. The next movement we have, you're gonna get into your downward dog and you're gonna walk it out. Walk out them hammies, walk out them calves. We got a good 30 seconds. So feel free to go slow even if you want to, or if you're feeling it, you can give a little mountain. And we have 10 seconds to go. Very good. 5, 3, and bring it down. Very good job, everyone. The next thing we're gonna have is the chakra sit. So you're gonna stand in parallel, your feet go outward on your hip bone line, and you stretch down. Booty out, chest forward, chest up, push. 3, 2, 1, go. Breathe in and out. Hi, kitty, in and out. 5 more seconds, in and out, in and out. Now we're just gonna do 30 seconds of our squat jumps, okay? Get ready, we're gonna give ourselves a little bit of time to get ready. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, down and breathe. In, out, 20 seconds, 10, five, and stop. Whoa. Ha. Let out whatever sounds you need to get out. Okay. We're gonna get back into that stance where you are, your feet are on the angle of your hips. Bend, lean, touch the ground, put your booty in the air, and just hang here for a little bit. Feel free to rock back and forth. Very good, everyone. Grab your water. Take a break. Water break, water break. All right, everyone, come back from your breaks in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 2, 1. Whew. How's everyone doing? Give me a thumbs up. Give me some gestures of movement. Let me know how you're doing. Good. What's a way you can give me a thumbs up without actually thumbing up? Show me. Yes. 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 Everybody. Okay. So, boom, boom, bada bing. We're going to transition into the next activity where we will be looking at the four laws of movement and then practicing each one. All right. We're going to start with the first law of movement, which is time and speed. Okay. So, as you can see here, you have your quick or your sustained actions, right? The one on the top, it's quick, right? The band in the orange is doing a dab that is incredibly quick, right? However, sustained is movement that happens what some would say more slowly, which is why I use the word fast and slow. Quick can be considered fast, sustained can be considered slow. So if we look at the next slide, we see the man running fast and we see the woman twerking slow. I think time is the easiest law for people to comprehend because it's something we deal with on the daily, directly. The second law of movement is space direction. On the left side, you can see direct or indirect path, right? In the section that says purse first, right? This is a winner of RuPaul's Drag Race who they are positioning the item in front of them. Their hand is going in that direction. And although their torso goes backward, there is one clear-cut direction. In terms of the man on the bottom, who is essentially hiding, I think that's Shaq, I don't know who that is. But essentially what's happening is he has a clear direction and then all of a sudden there is an impulse of movement that causes him to go into an indirect path. The reason that path is indirect is because path for us is ignited by the direction of predominantly the frontal part of the frontal axis, right? And we'll talk about axes later and what that means. But the front section of our body predominantly coordinates a direction and path. There definitely are times when ones can use another body part to coordinate a direct or an indirect path. But before we get to those logistics, in terms of the simpler understanding of direct versus indirect, direct is literally incredibly direct. Someone walking in an incredibly direct way or letting you know how they're gonna get to that place. Whereas if someone is moving in an indirect fashion, you're not really sure where they're gonna go next. The other aspect of space is not just your beeline, it's also levels. So in the section, you can see Maya dropping it low. In the second image, in the GIF in the middle, you can see the Fresh Prince of Brothers staying at that a kind of average level. And then the wife, which I aim to be one day, I aim for this to be me, is hopping down the aisle. So that's an obvious high level. If you got any questions, let me know. If not, I'm gonna keep moving forward. The third law of movement is weight or force. How heavy or light something or some action is. On the left side, you can see a mama dropping it down. She has a lot of weight in her arms, in her booty, in her knees, in her right foot. Whereas the couple on the right is giving you an incredibly, incredibly light force. Their movements have a slight bend in it, but there's not much power oomph kapow happening. The final and fourth law of movement that we're gonna look at today, move this over a little bit, is flow. Flow can be either bound or free, right? Bound flow is more like the white people on the top left, right? The people who are like kind of like giving you tension, giving you movement that really isn't free. It has a slight openness to it just because their arms are open, but in reality, it's movement that's pretty closed off. If you look at the living single intro on the bottom, all of that movement is free. All of that movement is free. If anyone needs any specific examples as per why it's free, I'll look at, what's her her name with the red? The little, okay, whatever. Sorry. If we're looking at the GIF, I can't remember her name. The one with the red shirt on, I think she's a perfect example of having an open body. There's not much tension that's going on here. There's a lot of loose relaxedness going on. So when you think of bound, think of like tension. And when you think of free, think of release, relaxed. In terms of the strategy for getting flow, what you do is you mix content, quality, and seasoning. And we're gonna know what content, what quality, and what seasonings are over the next final three sessions. For today, I'll give you an example. The first example is punch, throw, and impulse to get flow. You can see that Muhammad Ali is punching. He's throwing his punches, and they're all coming at an impulse. Impulse is something that happens very quickly. Whereas if you look at the second GIF at the bottom, that's more punch, flick, sustained. If you look at the differences between the punches, they're both punches, but one is a flick and the other one's a throw. One is an impulse and the other one is sustained. The other one happens slowly. Is that obvious? You can nod your head. I see your heads. Or if it's not obvious, let me know because I won't know. Very good. Thank you. All right. moving on, right? Those are the four laws of movement. So what I want to do right now is go back to the first law of movement. I want everyone to, not I want, please stand up on your mat. I don't know if they're frozen or not. Yes, very good. Stand up on your mat. We're going to practice time and speed first, right? And we're just going to do this with simple squats. So first, we're going to do a slow squat, right? Let's get into our root chakra sit. What you're going to do is, no, because I'm going to have to keep going back and forth. What you're going to do is, you're going to get back into that root chakra position where your feet are on that angle of your hips. We're going to go down slowly for a count of 10. 10, bend 9, down 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now let's go up 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's half time it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Half time it again. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right? Let's try to half that time that. We're going to do it on the count of 2. 3, 2, 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do all of that in a count of 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and pause. The difference between the 10 count and the 1 count is speed. Now let's go direct and indirect path, okay? What I'm gonna ask you to do is take your notebook in your hand. Take your notebook in your hand. Very good. All right, now what you're gonna do is you're gonna have your notebook in whatever hand you want, and you're gonna put it in that direction. So if it's in your left, it's pointing left. If it's in your right, it's pointing right. My book is in my left, so it points left, right? And I'm gonna look in that direction, and now I'm going to walk in that direction. And stop. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna flip the book to the other side, point, look, and you walk into any room, purse first. Very good. Purse first. Very good. Okay? This is like, if you're a person who wears purses, this will help you walk into any event looking fierce, right?
Yes.
Walking purse first. Purse first. Purse first. Yes. Okay? So, I love the commentary, by the way. Yes, yes, yes. I see you practicing over there, honey. What I want to give you is this, okay? The purse might be first, but the purse isn't leading, right? What happens is the purse is first and you are leading the purse. Is that clear?
Good.
Yes! I see the change. The purse isn't leading you. The purse is not wearing you. Okay. Very good, everyone. The next one we're going to do today is, low, average, and high levels. Oh, that one's simple. Okay, everyone, get back into your chakra sit, your chakra stance, where you're preparing for the chakra situation. Very good. All right, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna bend just a little bit. This is giving you average level. Average level. Like if you're trying to vogue from the 80s, you would get down to here, right? Right here. Now, if you go to the base of the chakra sit down here, boom. Congratulations, you are at low level. So low level, mid level. You could consider this high level, but I usually consider this average. I consider this if you're on the balls of your feet, which I'll show you what that looks like right now. What that means is you are lifting onto the balls of your feet and you're not leaning on your toes are actually relaxed and you're okay, right? So we have high, average, medium, low. Boom. All right. Now, the next thing we're going to do today, and I wish we were together, but to be honest, like, will be physical classes in the summer that I hope you'll go to, because it's very important for some of these actions to happen in pairs, like weight and force, because you really need to feel weight and feel force. So it's going to be hard for us to practice today, but I believe in us. What I'm going to ask you to do is take literally 60 seconds to find an object that is slightly heavy. You have 60 seconds to find an object that is slightly heavy that you can carry. Go. All right, everyone, you have 30 seconds to get your heavy object. Yo, when I go far from it, it gets really dark. All right. Let's come together. So I have my heavy object. I hope you have yours. And if you don't have it yet, you'll be here in time because we're going to start in 5 seconds. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your, you're going to take your heavy object. You can do this standing or sitting. It doesn't matter. I'm going to sit down. And what you're going to do is you're going to have your arms out and you're going to pass your object between your hands. Pass your object between your hands. Keep doing this. We're going to do this for 10 more seconds so that people who haven't started yet get to start. You're passing this object, very good, in between both hands. We're going to do this for 7 more seconds. Good. 5 more seconds. 3 more seconds. And very good. What you're going to do is you're going to push your object down, arms forward, open. And you're gonna fist one hand, switch the fist. Switch another hand, very good, switch the fist. Switch the fist, very good. Right? Now, the reason I wanted you to do that is to feel the difference between a heavy forced object and a light forced object, which is air or your hand, right? Now what I want you to do is we're gonna do this activity again, but we're gonna use no objects, right? And so, I'm gonna come closer. Sorry, y'all, this light for my computer is weird. But in using this object, what I want you to do right now is to open your arms again. Good. Now feel that object in your hand, right? It's in one hand, so one hand should feel heavier than the other hand, right? And then when you switch it, transfer the force of that feeling to the other hand. So if you remember the weight of the object that you carried, that's great. If you don't remember the weight, this is what I would do. Grab the object one more time, feel it, switch it, do that. Then what I would do is put that object on the ground. God, it's so dark. Put that object on the ground and then do it one more time. I would say it's as if you're miming the practice. Good. And when you feel the weight actually switch between these empty hands, that is you mastering force. That is you being able to conceptualize this is how much this has. I understand that this glass is lighter with less water in it because that is force. So... I just spilled water because it had a light force. All right. Ooh, and the last one we're going to do today is bound or free movement, which is flow, right? And the way that we're going to practice flow is actually by everyone come back, sit down, grab some water. We don't have much time left, but we're going to learn one way to practice flow. Boom, bada bing, bada boom, boom, boom. So going back to everything we learned today, this is flow here, which is bound or free. The way that you get flow is by mixing content, quality, and seasoning. Now, a way that we're gonna practice is by using the kinesphere. What is the kinesphere? I'm actually gonna ask folks, does anybody here know what a kinesphere is? Hell no, 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 no. Okay, that's cool, that's cool. So if we look at these pictures over here, the top left picture has a body practicing, right, dance in this circle, and that circle is in a square, right? A 3D, of course. To the right,
we have three different rectangles interacting with one another. And at the bottom, we have three people inside of this like kind of hexagonal shape, right? All of these shapes that you are seeing are basically all saying the same thing in different ways. The kinesphere is the distance that you are able to reach if you stand just on one or two legs. What I mean by this. Thank you. What I mean is this. I'm the only person to say this here. So, this area around me, this is my kinesphere. My kinesphere isn't over there because I'm standing right here. Now, if I am talking about maybe one plane, right? The kinesphere is made up of multiple planes. We are just gonna focus on three. The simplest plane to think about is the door plane, right? When you stand in a door, in the middle of a door, you have four corners, right? And those four corners make up that one. In our kinesphere exists our door plane. In our door plane exists four points, right? Point one, two, three, and four. The farthest point of my personal kinesphere is if I reach in any one of these points. That is how I know the farthest place that I can reach in my kinesphere. So, first we're gonna learn what the kinesphere is, and then we are going to practice it. Okay. So Laban describes it as the sphere around the body whose periphery can be reached by easily extended limbs without stepping away from that place, which is the point of support for when standing on one foot. I include 2 feet. There are 27 points total in our kinesphere. We will learn the main 12, right? So the first one is, well, this is another way to look at the planes, right? So I mentioned the door plane. Do you see the person standing on the left, the yellow orange person? Where it says coronal plane, that's the door plane. Where it says transverse plane, that is the table plane. And where it says sagittal plane, as if you cut your body in half from your face down, that's the sagittal plane or the wheel plane. When I was talking about axes earlier in terms of the front axis, the picture on the right shows you the different axes of rotation that we as humans have. So I'm gonna stand up and show you each of those things right now because we have longitudinal, transverse, and frontal axis. So, the frontal axis, oh, thank you, Mackenzie. Y'all are great. Because there's so much movement. All right, y'all. Boom, bada bing, bada boom. So, the frontal axis is literally all of this. It's all of this. It's like if I'm moving my body in this way, I am essentially engaging with my frontal axis, right? Now, if I'm engaging with my longitudinal axis, which focuses more on my sagittal plane, my wheel plane, this is my wheel plane, then my movements are going to be giving you like more of like this kind of like situation, this kind of like rotation around that top point. If I'm using my transverse, which is right here, that's the table plane, then most of those actions are going to be happening on kind of like a folding scale, right? So it's kind of like if you're cutting your body in half in all of these directions, when you do the door plane, your directions are mostly existing within that door plane. When you do the sagittal plane right here in the middle, your movements are more so like being able to mirror like in this place. And then when you're doing the table plane, those are kind of like movements that happen when you're more so incorporating the table right here. Oh, back and forth. All right, we're gonna work on the first plane now. Everyone, please stand up so that we can work on our table or transverse planes. Very good, very good, very good, very good, very good. I'm gonna keep this picture up so that you have a point of reference, right? So what we're gonna do is we are going to touch our hips and we're just gonna point in the four corners. Earlier when we were doing our root chakra, sit this right here, I told you that your hip bones had a direction, an angle leading outward. That angle actually helps you know what's the point of your two front points for your table plane, right? So one is here, to your right. One is here to your left. Good. One is behind you to your right, and one is behind you to your left. Very good. Keeping our feet in place with a slight bend, we are going to put our left hand on our hip and reach. Yeah, now I guess you can go out. That's one of the officials. You're going to reach to the right and come back. Now you're going to put your right hand on your right hip, left hand out. As far as you can, reach out to that point. Very good. And come back. Left hand on the hip, right hand out. Reach to the back. Come back. Left hand up, right hand in. Reach and come back. Good. Now that we know, what we're going to do is we're going to you do a two-hand reach. We're going to reach forward to those two points in the front, and we're going to come back. And with the side, we're going to reach backwards, and we're going to come back. Let's do that one more time. Reach forward to those two points in the front, and come back. And reach backward to those two points in the back, and come back. Very good. Very, very, very good. The table plane also works when you want to have isolated movement, right? And you want to talk about that isolation. So I can keep my top body parts like this, and I can move everything below that part of the transverse plane, or I can keep everything below the transverse plane, below the table plane still, and I can give you like, yes, like voguing is a very good example of how people use their transverse plane with isolation. Moving on to the next one, because we are slow on time. We have the door plane. The door plane I love so much. Stay where you are, but just look at the screen so you can see what the door plane is. Keep me in your corner because I'm going to be helping you practice the door plane. So, standing parallel. We know that one point is here. Let's touch our points. Point to the top right of us. Point to the top left. Bottom right, bottom left. Very good. One more time. Point to the top right, top left, bottom right, bottom left. Good. Now we have our door plane. What we're going to do is we're actually going to work on one foot with this one. Get on your right foot and lift your left one just a tad. Don't OD. Reach your right arm up toward that right point. Reach, 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 and come back. Good. Let's reach to the left one on one leg. Reach, 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 and down. Let's go down to the right. This one is pretty simple. And let's go down to the left. This one is also very simple. Good job. One more time. Reach. And reach to the left. And down. And down. Very good. The final part of our plane that we're going to talk about today is our sagittal plane. So I honestly love the sagittal plane, y'all. I'm going to stand to the side for this one so that you can see what we're doing, right? So imagine there's this big wheel. And what you're going to do is you're going to keep your 2 feet on the ground, hands on your hips, right hand, take it here, and reach your right hand forward. And you're reaching not just forward, you're reaching up, right? You're reaching up, 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 back, left hand. Down, reach down as far as you can go in terms of that frontal axis. Bring it back, right hand, you're reaching up here, try to touch that, and come back. Left hand, you're reaching down, this is the awkwardest one, I just wanna let you know. You're gonna reach back as far as you can go. Let's do these together. Okay, right arm, reaching forward and up, reach. Okay, left arm down, reach. Right arm up, reach. And then left arm down, reach. Shimashah. So, because we started with like 10 minutes later, I'm gonna take the next 10 minutes. However, if you need to go, feel free to do so. Thank you so much for coming today. We are going to use the next 10 minutes to finish our activity for today. So grab some water. And we're going to move on to our cool down and our stretch. And again, I apologize. We have a lot of music, but
I'm going to figure out music today and hopefully we'll have some tomorrow. So to do our cool down and our stretch, we're going to get on our mats and we're going to start with 30 seconds of planks. So please get back onto your mat. And we're going to start planks in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. And I'm doing the opposite. And out. In and out. Good. You have 15 more seconds. In, out. Keep it going. And out, in, out, in, out. Very good, come back. Now what we're gonna do is the pigeon sit. I'm gonna show you how to do the pigeon sit right quick, right? What you're gonna do is we're gonna start on the right. So get into this position right here. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take your right leg, right, and you're gonna put it on the other side of your left. If you need to, you know, use your hand for balance, that's fine, right? On the left side of your knee. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna crawl forward and you're going to lay down on that hammy and use your left leg to pull backwards. And you're gonna get into that same plank position and relax for 15. Breathe. Breathe. And know that when we're done this activity, we'll have a wonderful writing prompt. Breathe in, out, in. Out, 10 seconds, in, out, hands on either side, push your body up, get back up to that position, switch, right leg down, left leg up, left leg on the outside, crawl forward, right leg back, plank, and relax, 15, breathe. Okay, come back, lift it all up, bring that back around. The next activity that we're gonna do, is this. Okay, so we're gonna get back into this position here. I'm gonna put one leg forward like so. What you're gonna do is you're gonna lean forward, uncurl the left foot, put that booty in the air, and straighten that right leg. Bust slightly and don't go fast, right? Because it's the morning. Breathe in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. 5 more seconds, in, out, in, out. Rock it forward, very good. Let's actually get a little, some of this going on, up and down. And very good, bring it down. Come back. Very good. Left side. Oh my God, this is so dark. I don't know why it's so dark.
It's the window behind you, it's a silhouette.
Hey y'all, I'm sorry for this being dark. I'm trying my best. Okay. So, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna lift the left one. Very good. Right? We're gonna bend down, uncurl the right toe, lift that booty in the air. Ooh, and take your time straightening it. Sometimes I go a little too fast. Breathe in, out. In, out. Give a little bend if you need, if it's too much. And bring it back down. Let's give a little of this. Yes. And we're gonna come back to regular. The next thing we're gonna do, Child's pose. So let's actually do a proper child's pose because I'll be seeing mad people around New York City and places not doing it proper. So we're gonna get up here, right? We're making sure that our knees are under, our hips are under our shoulders. There's like a pipe, two pipes here, right? Then what we're gonna do is making sure our feet are uncurled. We're gonna, like we've been doing with our squats, booty out, chest forward, sit.
What you're gonna do is bring a little bit of skin from your knees up, right? I don't know if that makes sense, but basically lift, pull, down. Lift, pull, put back down. So you do less stress on your knees. Then you're guiding from your butt. You're gonna uncurl from your back, like so. And you're reaching forward before you relax. That's the biggest thing that I don't see. Imagine your hands are spiders and they are reaching forward, and then you get to relax. And once you relax, crawl the spiders forward just a little bit more to ensure that you get stretch in your ribs. Breathe in, out, relax your head. Breathe in, out, very good. We're gonna take our right hand and crawl that spider over on top of our left hand. Breathe. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Crawl the right spider back, crawl it forward a little bit. Take the left spider, crawl it forward a little bit, crawl it over to the right hand. Breathe in and out. In and out. Crawl that hand back, crawl both hands forward. Breathe in and out. In and out. Relax your arms. Very good. Breathe in and out. In and out. What we're going to do is we're going to come to tabletop. Come to tabletop. After you're in tabletop, what you're going to do is you're going to move your right leg next to your left. Extend your left leg. Sit on your booty. Turn around. Lay your ass down. Like this. You're going to make sure that we still have those two poles, right? My poles exist from my shoulders to my hips to my knees, right? Like if my knees are like this, then my pole is not connected. But if I put my knees back, and if this camera was on top of me, you would be able to see that there's a direct line going from my ankles to my knees to my hips to my shoulders. Now that I'm here, I'm going to put my hand on my belly, right? And we're going to play a game called Fill the Balloon. Do is you're gonna breathe all the way to your diaphragm through your nose, breathe in and fill that balloon and let it out. Now let's see if we can make that balloon a little bigger. Breathe into your diaphragm all the way to the bottom of your stomach and hold it and blow out the candles. I can't hear you, but it's incredibly important if you breathe in through your nose and you can hear it, like, and when you breathe out, you can hear it like blowing candles. Five more times. Balloon. Hold it. Blow out the candles. Good. Four count. Four, three, two, one. Hold it. Let it out with four count. You are an ocean, so you should hear yourself when you breathe in and out. Breathe in. Hold it. And breathe out. Two more times. Breathe in. Feel your hands rise. Breathe out. Blow out the candles. One more time. Breathe in. And breathe out. Fill your balloon four more times by yourself. Breathe in and breathe out. Keep doing that while I set something up. Breathe in and breathe out. When you come to your fourth, I'm going to ask you to lay in Shavasana. I'm sorry, I'll read the comments now. Let's lay in Shavasana. If you don't know what Shavasana is, what you're going to do is... Uncurl your... Still learn how to use this Zoom. It is my first time, but I think we did a pretty good job today. So in light of the fact that we are 7 minutes over, what I want to do is have a little checkout, give you writing prompts, and unfortunately today we won't be able to go over the writing prompts because of time, but I'll be sure that next week when we do our next class, we will have time for the writing prompts to look at them together. And for anyone who comes next week, if you feel comfortable sharing what you wrote after today's prompts, there will be space next week for that situation. One, I wanna say thank you all so much. I have been having a lot of insecurity and fear around home to not only sustain myself, but also how I'm going to preserve my passions as we exist in an era of not knowing a lot of things and, you know, long-term planning is weird right now. So I thank you for believing in that process. I thank you for investing in the process. I thank you for taking in the process. Although we are not physically with one another, this workshop was just as beneficial for me as workshops that I've done with people in person. So I appreciate all of you. In terms of checking out, I just wanna hear some responses of what people thought, what people experienced, and what people want, what you want, if that's clear. Feel free to just speak up. So I'll repeat that one more time for everyone before we finish this class. I would like to know, in terms of the course today, something that you appreciated, something that was difficult, or something that you want to do next time.
Somebody wrote, can you do a chat?
Oh. I forgot that was a whole chat situation. This is really incredible, so thank you for holding our hearts and being our beings. Aw, thank y'all. Aw. Okay, I love it. All right, so we will end the class today with our writing prompts. So what I'm going to ask you to do is write down these two prompts and give yourself 5 minutes for each prompt. Say that one more time. Write down these two prompts. Give yourself 5 minutes for each prompt. And the first prompt is, I give respect and love to my body via. I'll repeat that. I give respect and love to my body via. Via just means by way of, through. I'll repeat that one final time. I give respect and love to my body via. It'll take 5 minutes on that. The second prompt is this. I give respect and love to my body because. Oh my God, you're so brilliant.
Right. Got you.
Prompt two. You got me. Respect and love to my body. Oh, sorry. Make sure when we write body, we are capitalizing body. That's the only thing that I will ask. Like that, body. Take 5 minutes on each prompt. And I'm excited to say that next week we'll be able to go over some prompts. We'll be able to, like, even the prompts that we do today, we'll talk about them. For newcomers, we will go over what are somatics and, you know, what are somatic sessions. And we will do geography next week. So, this week was more about comprehending. Next week is more about applying. So I hope to see all of you next week. Thank you so much for coming today. Also, I'm gonna figure out how to get the music on the situation so that we can be dancing to the music with the situation.
We'll work on it together. We got you.
I am playing music right now. So next week it's gonna be better. It's gonna be just like much better, okay? We're gonna need technological like theory. Okay. Thank you all so much. So much. Please come to all of the next three classes. It's gonna be.
We love you.
Thank you.
Ciao. Do I just like sign out? Good.